Can you say daddy plays video games?
Daddy's training a drink.
Hey guys, coming out of here, and in the background you see the game Morphies Law. Now, I saw this on a website that I'm a part of as a YouTuber, and I just had to play it. First off, this is a sponsored video. They did provide the key for me by the developers at Cosmoscope. Now, with that being said, I definitely want to bring a lot of the benefits and then a couple of the drawbacks that I did notice of the game. But all in all, this game is crazy. Now, as the developer says about this game on their Steam page, Morphies Law is a wacky, mass-stealing, robot-morphing 3D shooter with a simple basic law. When you get hit by others, they shrink and you grow. That's a very basic, broad scope brush of a game that has a lot of depth for only $20 and being an indie developer and publisher. So what is it? You play as what's called like a Morphie, right? It's this nutty third-person shooter character that's stylized in like a Dia de las Muertas, Day of the Dead kind of art style. Now, the art style and humor, as you see in the background of this game, is really, really well done. They didn't deviate and do like Day of the Dead, you know, theme here, and then they went crazy theme here. No, they stuck with it, right? They stayed in what they want to do, and I believe it's really, really well done, especially coming from the Southwest. I see that stuff all the time. This game does a great job of not taking itself too seriously, right? Having fun. So examples of this is you can play an unlimited demo of the game called Fart Night, where you can unlock pieces of the game. When you want to, like, when you're going through the options pages and you want to go, like, do you want to quit? And you're like, yeah or nah. You know, everything about this game is fun. Nothing in here is taken too seriously. When your character boost jumps, it comes out of, well, I mean, Fart Night. So, I mean, you get the picture of where it comes out of. So, I think the game's draw is its humor and its uniqueness, right? I think another really cool part of the game, or unique part of this game, comes with the play itself, right? This Morphies, like what it said. So when you shoot somebody, they shrink and you grow. So you might be seeing this in the background, right? So your Morphie shoots another one and you grow when they shrink. So in that area that you shot, you wind up with these crazy combinations of characters. So if I shoot a Morphie in the arm, the right arm, my right arm is going to grow. If I'm shooting a Morphie in the legs, my legs are going to grow. And there is a cause and effect for that to happen, right? So the map has all of these traps on it. And so if you're too big, you're gonna get killed by these traps. If you're too small, you can't get up to certain areas of the map like you would if you had big giant legs, because the game, like I had said, has a lot of depth to it. And so as you grow and your legs get bigger, you'll see in the menus, you get a buff basically for your bigger legs. If your arms get bigger, if your head gets bigger, if your chest gets bigger, everything has a unique combination and aspect to it, which makes the game really enjoyable. So the other thing that I thought is kind of cool is this game came out on Switch, and now it's on PC, and there's crossplay, which is becoming more and more of a normal thing, and I love it as a PC player. So they're playing this game on their Nintendo Switches, and we get to play on mouse and keyboard. So as they actually advertise, and I will reiterate, go dominate these console peasants that are on Switch. I've played a few rounds and had a blast each time, and I decimated each time I played. I don't think there's a really huge player base on PC, but the game is absolutely brand new. I believe the game just came out very recently. Yeah, it came out July 30th. So it's a little over 2 months old right now. And so for a $20 game, there's a tremendous amount of customization. So the weapons you can customize, like I had said, the Morphies you can customize very in depth. You even have special powers. There's lots of different game modes. So they have done a great job optimizing this game. Now, there are a few drawbacks, right? So the actual, you know, it's a third-person shooter versus a first-person shooter. So if you like that, that's great. I'm not a huge fan of third-person shooters. I have a hard time sticking with them because I like the gunplay of a first-person shooter. There isn't a very large player base on PC, but, you know, that only happens when people dive into the game and try it. And then you can tell, I mean, there are some, you know, there are some janky ways that your Morphe interacts with the map sometimes, but that comes from just being an indie studio and indie devs. And so even with that, there are a few drawbacks, but from my opinion, this is a game that anybody is going to have a lot of fun trying out and having fun with. I'm not getting paid to say that. I'm not getting any sort of affiliate link for that at all. I'm just saying from my perspective, for $20 on Steam, it's a real hoot. It's a lot of fun to play, and definitely something that I'll be doing once in a while between Overwatch and Call of Duty when you need a break and just to go have fun running around in this one of these crazy huge Morphies or tiny Morphies. That's what I'll probably be doing. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I think links and information is going to be down in the bottom with some more stuff about the game. Let me know if you've played it, if you've seen it, if you watched a video of it, or if you're one of the Morphe developers that happens to see this video. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.